So what's going on, guys? DIY Dan here, and this is another wakeboarding video. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to replace the lacings and lacing locks on a set of bindings. And then after that, because it's not going to take long, I'm going to show you guys some of my wakeboarding and wake surfing skills, or lack thereof, to some good tunes. So let's get to it. If you're just here for my epic failures, go ahead and bypass to 4 minutes. That's when it gets started. So my setup is a Ronix. I run a bandwagon board with district bindings. Now anybody that's in this sport knows that bindings, and boards for that matter, aren't cheap. And the thing that most commonly goes out on a set of bindings is your lacings or your lacing locks. In case you're wondering what's in the bottle, that's just some dish soap diluted with water. And it makes it much easier to get into your bindings, especially if they're dry or a tight fit. And as soon as you get in the water, it washes right out. So honestly, I don't use that bottle much anymore. However, back in the day when I used to run a hyperlite high back binding, it was absolutely necessary to get into those bindings. So the only reason I actually was strapping into these bindings right now was to show you guys that these were loosening up on me. However, it didn't happen as bad, probably because the lacings were dry and not as slippery. So over the last 20 years of being in this sport, I've changed out several lacings and lacing locks. And this is a very economical way to make your bindings last longer, so you don't necessarily have to go buy a new set. So a buddy of mine actually gave me 4 lacing locks because he had bought a whole box of them. However, I did go on Amazon and do a search for lacing locks, and they come with or without the lacings. And there is a wide variety depending on the style you want. So on my bindings, on the end cap that holds the laces, it was just a rubber boot that I had to unclip off of the plastic that allowed me to access the lacings. This is on a set of hyperlite bindings, and you just push them out through the end. My old liquid force bindings, same story, just push it out. I have seen some that have screws holding the end caps on as well, but there will be a way to easily disassemble that so you can access the lacings and remove the locks. So right here, I'm just removing that rubber off of the end cap. I lightly pried it up so it would unsnap out of the plastic. Then I went ahead and cut the knots that were holding the laces in the end cap so I could slide the lacing lock off of the lacings. Now, I did not have to do the lacings on my bindings because they were still in good shape. It was just the locks, but obviously you would just unstring them and string them back together. After removing the old lace locks, I did take a lighter to the end of the lacings just to make sure that the lacings wouldn't start fraying over time. So the lacing locks my buddy gave me were spring loaded. So all I had to do was push that spring down, feed the lacings through the lock, and then put the end cap back on. So these locks had an emblem on the push button, and it was probably supposed to go up. However, I tried it in the up position and then I flipped them over and tried it in the down position. And it was just more comfortable for me to release the lacings with that push button on the bottom. So obviously that's personal preference. So I don't even know what style of knot Ronix was using in these end caps. I just ended up doing a double overhand knot and pulling it tight. There was also some type of an adhesive that helped hold the rubber to the plastic end cap. I just used some waterproof silicone and put a dab on each side. Then just placed the rubber over the plastic end cap and snapped the rubber into place, making sure it squeezed a little bit of that silicone out, and then cleaned it up with a paper towel because some was oozing out the side. That's gonna wrap it up for this part of this video, guys. The rest of this video is just me wake surfing and wakeboarding. And honestly, the crashes were a lot more entertaining than the stuff I landed. So that's what the majority of the rest of this video is. Enjoy, and hope to see you next time.
To move.
Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you next time. Have a good one. Later.